Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. I'm Mr. Hinman with another lesson in the art room at Fairview Elementary School. Today we will be reading the story of Miss Rumphius by Barbara Cooney. This is a great story to read as young artists because it inspires us to do something to make the world more beautiful. The flowers that you see here are called lupines, and those were Miss Rumphius' favorite flowers. Miss Rumphius liked lupins so much that people called her the Lupin Lady. She had three things that she wanted to do with her life. She wanted to travel to faraway places, she wanted to live by the sea, and she wanted to do something to make the world more beautiful. Let's read and see what that might be. The Lupin Lady lives in a small house overlooking the sea. In between the rocks in her house grow blue and purple and rose-colored lupins. The Lupin Lady is little and old, but she has not always been that way, for I know she is my great aunt and she told me so. Once upon a time, she was a little girl named Alice who lived in a city by the sea. From the front stoop, she could see the wharves and the bristling mass of tall ships. Many years ago, her grandfather had come to America on a large sailing ship. Now he worked in a shop at the bottom of the house, making figureheads for the prows of ships and carving Indians out of wood to put in front of cigar stores. For Alice's grandfather was an artist. He painted pictures too. Sometimes when he was very busy, Alice would help him painting in the skies. In the evening, Alice would sit on her grandfather's knee and hear stories of all the faraway places that he'd traveled to. When he had finished, Alice would say, "I too want to travel to faraway places. I too want to live by the sea." "That's all very well, little Alice," he tells her, "but there's a third thing you must do for me. You must do something to make the world more beautiful." "Okay," she says, but she doesn't yet know what that will be. Then when my great aunt Alice was grown up, she set out to do the three things she promised her grandfather she would do. She moved far away from the city in the salty air, and she worked in a library, dusting the shelves and putting the books back where they belonged so people could find them. People called her Miss Rumphius now. Sometimes in the middle of the day, she would take walks to the conservatory. On a cold, snowy day, she would step inside and the warm, moist air would cover her. The smell of jasmine filled her nose. "This is almost like a tropical isle," said Miss Rumphius, "but not quite." So Miss Rumphius left and traveled to a tropical island. Miss Rumphius traveled all over the world, just as she promised her grandfather she would. My great aunt, Miss Alice Rumphius, climbed tall mountains where the snow never melted. She saw lions playing and kangaroos jumping. And everywhere she went, she made friends she would never forget. Once, when she was in the desert riding a camel, she fell off and she hurt her back. "What a foolish thing to do," she thought. "Well," Miss Rumphius said, "I have certainly seen faraway places. Maybe it's time to find my place by the sea." And it was, and she did. From the porch of her new house, Miss Rumphius watched the sun come up in the morning. She watched it cross the heavens and sparkle on the water, and she saw it set in glory each evening on the sea behind her house. She started a little garden among the rocks around her house. She planted her favorite kind of flowers, lupins. Miss Rumphius was almost perfectly happy, but there was one more thing that she promised her grandfather she would do. She needed to do something to make the world more beautiful, but she didn't know what that would be yet. "The world is already so nice," she thought. The next spring, Miss Rumphius was not well. Her back was bothering her again. She had to stay in bed most of the time. The flowers she had planted the summer before were coming up outside her window, blue and purple and rose-colored lupins. She could smell them from the open window. "Lupins," she said. "Oh, how I love lupins. I wish I could plant more of them this year." But her back was bothering her, and she could not. After a hard winter, another spring came the following year. Miss Rumphius was feeling better and she could get out of bed. She was able to take a nice long walk. Well, when she crossed over the hill on this path, she had found something on the ground. "I can't believe my eyes," she cried as she knelt in delight. Lupins! There were blue and purple and rose-colored lupins in the valley. "It must have been the wind from my garden that brought the seeds here." Then Miss Rumphius had a wonderful idea. She hurried home and got out her seed catalogs. She ordered 5 bushels of lupin seeds. She took long walks all summer long throughout town, throwing the lupin seeds all in the grass. Well, people called her the crazy old lupin lady now. The next spring, there were lupins everywhere. Fields and hillsides were covered with blue and purple and rose-colored lupins. Miss Rumphius had done the third most challenging, most exciting thing of all. She found a way to make the world more beautiful. My great aunt, Miss Alice Rumphius, is very old now. Her hair is very white. Oftentimes, my friends and I will come and stand outside her fence. When she sees us there, she asks us in. She tells us stories of faraway places. When she's finished, I tell her, "I too want to travel to faraway places, just like you. I too want to live by the sea like you." "That's all very well, little Alice," she tells me. "But there's a third thing you must promise to do for me." "What's that?" I ask her. She says, "You must do something to make the world more beautiful." "All right," I say, "but I don't yet know what that can be." So today we're going to be starting a painting of some lupin flowers like the ones you see here. You will need a light blue piece of paper. You will also need your water cup with just a little bit of water in it. You don't want very much in there, and you really don't need very much in there. You'll need a paper towel. You'll need your paintbrush. If you have a bigger paintbrush than this one, that's okay, but this is the one that I had to give you. You will also need your green paint only. You do not need the blue or the purple, so you can just keep those closed and off to the side. The green is the only one you'll use today. Carefully open this paint. Make sure you are in a place where you have something underneath your paper, like a bigger piece of paper or newspaper or something to catch extra paint so it doesn't get on your table. And make sure you're in a part of your house or daycare where you're allowed to use paint. Make sure your paper's going side to side, not up and down. Side to side. We're going to use green paint, and we're going to use this to paint the grass. Now, grass doesn't grow in the sky, so it's not going to be up high. It's going to be down by the bottom. Grass grows up from the ground, not side to side, so your paint lines are going to come upwards from the bottom, like that. Use your paintbrush moving in an upward motion to paint your grass. You're going to make some of the lines a little bit longer than others, whereas some will be a little bit shorter. Go ahead and fill up the whole bottom edge of your paper with green grass lines of paint that come up from the bottom. Once you have done that, you're going to paint some flower stems. A flower stem is just a long, skinny line that goes up. You don't want to put them right on top of each other, so give yourself a little bit of space in between each flower stem. Make them come up nice and high so you have a lot of space to paint your flowers. It doesn't matter how many stems you do. You can make 4, 5, 6, 7. I made 7 here, and I think that looks good. You just don't want a million of them that will take you too long and you won't have space. Once you have completed this part, put your painting somewhere safe where it can dry. Also, throw away your extra piece of paper that was underneath that was just catching paint. That way, your table is clean and you don't get the wet paint anywhere where it doesn't belong. Carefully close up your green paint. Make sure you push the lid on tight so that it snaps on all the way around. You don't want it drying out because we will need to use it again. Always take good care of your paint brushes. So use your water cup to carefully swish the brush around in there and wash off all the green paint. You want to get it as clean as can be. Once it's very, very clean, dry it off on the paper towel. Never leave your paintbrush in the cup. You don't want to leave it in there and let it dry like that. That will ruin the paintbrush. Take good care of your brush. Always dry it off and leave it laying flat. Great job today. I hope you guys had fun. I will see you next time.